U.S. investments and remittances to the Philippines are feared to take a hit from another Trump presidency. On ANC this morning, RCBC chief economist Michael Ricafort said this would be on possibly more protectionist policies by the Republican nominee. He also expects higher U.S. tariff on Chinese goods that could in turn affect the world economy. In contrast, Ricafort said a Harris White House could mean lesser worries or tensions between two of the world's biggest economies. The U.S. and China have been on a trade war since 2016 or 2018 as Washington hiked import dues and set trade barriers with China.
There may be some adverse effects when it comes to, well, foreign investments being moved elsewhere outside the U.S., including the Philippines, and of course, jobs being lost in the U.S. to outside the U.S., such as on BPOs, and also, well, of course, the on remittances. There could also be, because the tighter immigration rules would also partly adversely affect when it comes to remittances sent home by Filipinos from the U.S. The markets have also priced in a possible Kamala Harris victory. And what would that mean for the Philippines? It's an inverse of what's expected on a Trump victory, meaning to say there would be less concerns on inflation due to the intensified U.S.-China trade war in terms of higher import tariffs by the U.S. from China. And of course, there would be less deficit spending, and that would mean lower bond yields.
Now, Donald Trump believes his performance in that debate was his best, he told his reporters following the face-off during which Harris appeared to repeatedly get under the former president's skin.
All I do is say the truth. I say the truth. If I lose votes or gain votes, I don't care. But this was my best debate. I thought it was very good. I thought she was very weak on foreign policy. She was very weak on the border. And I'm very happy.
Kamala Harris, meanwhile, addressed her supporters at a watch party right after the Philadelphia debate. She said it was a good day for her, but reminded her supporters that the job is not yet done.
I think we all know that tonight was a night that highlights something that you all have been working so hard on. We have folks here who have been knocking on doors. Well, you know, we have a lot of work to do, okay? And tonight, I think, highlighted for the American people what's at stake.
Grab Philippines justifies its surge pricing even during the wee hours of the day. The ride-hailing firm's director for public affairs said this is mainly due to supply and demand. Bui Bonifacio explained Grab only has around 45,000 drivers, servicing up to 1 million passengers. She adds the lion's share of the surge pricing goes to the driver as an incentive.
We're always perpetually in a state of yung demand po mas malaki kesa po dun sa supply, and based po dun sa economic principles, then magsa-surge pricing po talaga tayo. Kung mas madami po yung nagbubok ng ride, tas konti po yung driver, then kahit po 3 o'clock ng umaga, then magsa-surge din po talaga yung presyo natin. But we're continuously working po with LTFRB para po mas maging robust po yung supply natin.
The Philippine Budget Department releases nearly 32 billion pesos for the salary hike of state workers. Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman urged heads of the government and the departments as well as agencies to immediately distribute the wage increase, since these are retroactive starting January of this year. The hike is in accordance with the Salary Standardization Law 6, which President Marcos signed last August 2. The DBM website also now has a Salary Standardization Law dashboard, which provides real-time data on the budget releases.